Hello and welcome back with this amazing panel. I'm so excited. Oh my god, what a panel we have. And did you guys follow the previous round?
I did. I didn't get it from the beginning, but I watched the last 15 minutes or so.
Oh, that's awesome. In the previous, in some tournament in Maharashtra Inauguration League also, you had played against Vishy Anand. I can't remember who won that match. I'm pretty sure it was not Amir, but this is your rematch.
This is my chance.
So excited. So many amazing talented people here. Guys, what is the strategy? Let's start with Arijit ji. What is your strategy today?
I am going to learn new games today because last time I played, I was a child. So, and it's an honor to play against Vishy Anand. Come on. Like, what else do you want?
Absolutely. And when you were talking before, we just went live, you were mentioning that this is the first time that all of you are playing live online. You played chess, of course, otherwise, but online, it's your first time.
No, I've played online earlier. Once or twice. Actually, I don't really play online, but once or twice.
And yeah, Amir, now you, everybody in the chess world knows that you just love chess. You play it on set. We've all read the stories. We've all heard it. We know, and the Maharashtra Chess League, you played against Anand. So not surprised at all that you were also following the first segment of this. Have you made some special preparation for today?
No, unfortunately, I haven't because I'm shooting tomorrow since the lockdown has opened. So we have a 2-3 days stint of shooting. So I've been busy preparing for that. So unfortunately, I've not prepared at all. Actually, there is a game I've been playing very regularly. I don't know if you've heard of this game, Vishy. It's called Settlers of Catan. Have you heard of this? It's a strategy game, but there's some amount of chance in it. So I've been playing that.
Were you playing this when we met in a few years back? I was supposed to take you up and I haven't.
Now it is. It's online. So you can go to Catan Universe and then we can actually play. We'll do that. I'll
okay, deal.
That's awesome. So I've not been playing any chess, as you can see.
And, you know, yeah, go on, Anand.
My strategy is just to try and last as long as I can.
Anand, you know what happened last time we had our panelists say that? Just about 1 hour ago, and then they were just so impressive on the board.
Yeah. What can I say? You can't trust them.
Yeah. we all know that this is an exhibition match, and Vishy is being really kind to us. And he's allowing us to play and allowing us to last for as long as he decides he lets us last.
You know, guys, Ananya ji used to be a very, very strong state level player. And I have this intel, Ananya ji, that you've been training with a grandmaster. Can you tell us about that?
No. I used to play about like 8-9 years ago when I was 15, 16. It was a lot of fun. I haven't played since then. So it's really an honor to play against Vishy, sir. I'm looking forward to it. Yeah. I hope I can survive maybe until I castle, if we castle, hopefully. First 15, 20 moves. So please go a little bit easy on me. I'm actually really nervous. I'm looking forward to it. It's an honor to be here and it's for a great cause. So thank you.
Yeah, Ananya, we are so excited. Now, we know that you used to play quite regularly when you were 15, 16. You played in the state championship. We've seen this happen all around that once you get into chess, it's just so addictive and people just can't leave it. Did that happen to you as well, even though you moved on from playing tournaments and were not playing actively, but did you still stay in touch with the game?
You know, unfortunately, I think after I got into music, I've become so obsessed with it that I sort of just left all my other hobbies aside. I think, you know, after this game, after doing the puzzle battles and stuff on chess.com, I genuinely feel like, oh, it's really like helping my mind, you know, stay focused and just helping in life in general. So I'm probably going to start playing again. My mom says I should play, so I'm probably going to listen to her. Mom's know best.
That's true. Same, what better way to kickstart playing again than a game against Vishy himself?
Yeah. And you're talking about mom. So I have a special small request from Amir. You know, my mom is watching this and she never does this, but she has messaged me. Can you please give a shout out to my mom, Sweetie Raina? She's watching this. She'll be super happy.
Sweetie ji, aap mere liye prarthna kariye ki main matlab izzat reh jaye meri bas.
Okay, mommy, please send Google Pay after this. All right. And Manuji, how are you feeling today? What is going on in your head today? Like, you're not as strong as just player, is what the intel I have, but what are you feeling today?
Very, very nervous. I used to play chess as a kid, but I haven't played for like many, many years. And Vishiji, it is a huge honor to be just like meeting you, leave aside playing against you. When I was growing up, I always looked up to you. Like you were one of the heroes that everybody used to talk about. My parents, relatives saying, "Kabhi kisi din, you should become like Vishwanath Anand." So it's a huge privilege to be just here. Super excited. And hugely nervous when Prachura called me and said, "Ki Manu, don't worry, we'll have 30 minutes. So I was thinking in my mind, 30 minutes is too long. Even if I last for 5 minutes, maybe it would be a huge achievement. So I just want to enjoy.
That's up to you.
Let's
take
your
time.
I'm going to take time. Correct. That's
So much fun. And Manoj, your kids are like huge fans of Vishy Anand. Am I right?
Yes, yeah. I have a 7-year-old son and he plays chess. In fact, he plays better than me.
Wow.
And he's a huge fan. So when I told him that I'm doing this match and who is going to be there, Vishy sir, he was more excited than I was. Like, he's a huge, huge fan of yours.
Is he around?
He's around. Let me just call him.
And his name is Jordan, right? His name is Jordan after Michael Jordan. You've named after
yes,
him.
Yes, his name is Jordan after Michael Jordan.
Wow.
So this is Jordan. Jordan, come say hi.
Hello, Jordan.
Hello.
Wow. Anand, because Jordan is such a big fan, what would you want to say to him right now? Can you see him?
Manuji, Jordan is not visible. Can he come towards the right? Because we have cut in the square.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, we got him.
Okay.
Hi, Jordan.
Okay.
Hello.
Are you going to be helping your dad?
Yes.
Oh. Wow.
It's not the answer I was hoping for. Do you play a lot?
Yes.
Okay, great.
Wonderful.
Awesome.
And especially because Manu just mentioned that Jordan is a better player than Manu.
That is true, actually.
So guys, we'll be starting this match right after this 10 seconds break. We'll be taking a break so that the OBS is set up. So all the best to all the players over here. You'll be getting signed to copies of Anand's book, Mind Master. And it'll be a very, very exciting thing to have. And guys, can you please ask everybody to donate because all the money is going for great cause.
Totally, yeah.
So guys, please keep donating whoever's watching this. We'll be right back. Welcome once more. Yes, guys, it's the second panel and this time they have a different strategy. Tanya, Parshura is also joining us in this commentary box today. The strategy that this team has used is ki ye log ne bola hai humko Zoom mute nahi rakhna hai, humko beech beech mein baatein karni hai, humko Vishy sir ko distract karna hai. Do you think, Tanya, that's a great strategy? I feel it's a good strategy.
I think it could work, Samir, but we also know that Anand was mentioning that he's pretty ready after what happened in that first segment to take them on with all his shield and everything. And not only do they have a new strategy, we will also be able to hear them while they share their thoughts. So when they talk, we will probably just listen to what they are saying. Now, Amir mentioned ki he will try singing a song to distract Vishy, but mujhe pata nahi that will distract Vishy more or Arijit more. We don't know what's going to happen.
So after MD on the board, I remember the video.
Oh, Amir is also playing on the board.
Amir is mentioning that you can't disturb me because I'm playing the world champion right now. He does have a point. But we do know that Manu's son, Jordan, is ready to help him. Samir, do you think Jordan is going to come in and rescue his dad?
Anandji just asked him casually, "Are you going to help him?" And yes.
And he said it with so much determination and confidence. I loved it.
Okay,
so, Samir, we do have liftoff.
Let's have a look at Amir's game right now.
It's on and we see now again Vishy will be starting all boards with the white pieces. 30
standard.
Minutes
okay.
Each of the players, no increment. We saw them, they were a little surprised that it started already. Let's not forget that they don't have so much practice in online chess.
Yeah, e4, e5, knight f3, knight
wow.
f6. So many people, so many YouTubers out there must be noting these games right now. Okay, let's have a note, let's
Look
analyze these games.
And this one especially, now Amir is the only player who's actually played against Anand pehle at the Maharashtra Chess League, and he is somebody who plays a lot of chess. Unke paas bahut chess knowledge hai, and you can make that out from his opening choice. We have the Italian on the board, Bishop C4, played by Vishy, and it's going to be interesting to see. And look at this, Amir going for a very topical line. He goes for Knight F6. The only thing he needs to know here, Samir, is that if Vishy plays Knight G5, attacking that pawn on F7, the only move that Black has in his position.
Can I guess? D5.
Go for it.
D5. Yeah,
that is correct. Well done. D5 is the only move. So Amir needs to know this opening. Otherwise, he can be in big trouble after Knight G5. Knight G5, Vishy goes for it. He goes for it, Samir. Will he play D5?
My God.
Amir needs to find D5. He's taking his time, which means...
Come on, Amir.
Yeah, come on, Amir. You have to play D5, because the point is that Knight G5 and Bishop on C4, both are eyeing this pawn on F7.
D5 is a must.
How do you defend it?
D5, guys, do you think Amir will find, if he plays D5, it, you know why, can you show that line?
D5,
E takes on D5, and here you have to find the move Knight A5.
Well done, Samir Raina.
So this is not easy, and I know this because mereko ratta hai ye position. Main kitni baar hara hu is position mein, that's why I know. But let's see the live analysis, what's happening, what's
live analysis, and
let's see what happens.
Amir thinking here, he hasn't made his move. I'm a little worried at this point, because if not D5, he is lost on the spot.
What do you think, Parchura? Will Amir find D5?
I think he's a pretty good player.
I think also, you know, our method of action, Parchura, like he will not be able to find a way to actually defend the F7 pawn. Then you sort of just elimination, the process of elimination, you realize this is the only move.
Right. No, I have confidence in Amir, sir. I think he's going to play D5.
Wow. All right.
I'm predicting D5.
Chat, do you think? Chat, what do you think, guys? Please keep the donation.
Oh, he did it.
He
found it. Come on. Come on, sir.
Amir OP in the chat.
Come on, guys.
But this is just the start, Prachara. Samir, this is just the start. Because the problem is that the move Knight D5 is not a good idea here. It's the most obvious move, recapturing that pawn. But the problem with this move is that I think it lands into some trouble after Knight F7. I'm not sure. Samir, what is the line here? Is it Knight F7 here?
I can see is my mother has super chatted 2,199 rupees. Thank you, Mom, for the super chat. Chat, is the echo gone? Let us know if the echo is gone. We have done our best to remove it. And if you have any inconveniences, let me know. I'm your customer care. And yes, Tanya, please, you were saying Knight F7.
So my point is that in this is our live board, Samir. Now, as you mentioned, Knight A5 is the only move for Black. The natural-looking recapture runs into Knight F7. You're forking the queen and the rook. So Black has to capture the knight. White gives a check. Yep. Maybe there are some other lines which are stronger, but this is the one that comes to my mind. Ab ye knight bhi hanging hai. Only move, King E6 to defend the knight.
Oh.
We put more pressure with Knight C3 and it's game over.
Nikhilji, can you mute Prachura on Discord and allow his audio from Google Meet so the echo will be gone? And meanwhile, this is a very interesting position. I'm so sorry I lost the track of it, but what happened
let's
in this game?
Let's see. So he's thinking. So very important moment for Amir. He needs to find Knight A5. Abhi wo soch raha. He goes Knight D5 and Vishy plays D4. Another very strong move here, really. Opening up the bishop and the center. I wonder if Knight F7, if there's a problem with it, or Vishy just wants to go a little easy on Amir. I don't know. We'll find out afterwards. But Samir, let's move on. Prachara, let's take a look at the other openings that we have here.
We have Arijit Singh's game over here. Can we take it from the top?
Let's start from the start. And Arijit starting with the queen's pawn opening, which is basically moving your pawn in front of the queen. So these are called all queen's pawn openings. And he develops his knight after E3. So bishop F4. Samir, what's the name of this opening? Do you know what this is called?
Yes, it's called queen's pawn opening accelerated London system.
Well done.
No, he cut on the... Hey, Samir, you're cheating, man.
Come on, man.
You can see that.
Why are you not happy for brother?
Where do you see this stuff? Oh, I see where you see it. Okay.
Sure, there's a echo on your end. But that's...
What do I do? What do I do, guys?
I have no idea here. I am customer care. I am not, client care.
Should I come on Discord?
So... probably you should come on Discord and mute yourself on Google Meet and on Zoom as well. Meanwhile, Anand continuing to develop, Arijit continuing to develop. I like this move, bishop b4 check, but it does fall into this move c3, defending the check, attacking the bishop. Oh my god.
Oh, Arijit.
I think Arijit is already lost. This position is already lost.
Chat, this move is not a good idea. The bishop was attacked. He had to fall back because now Anand picks up a piece. And the point is that this bishop is pawn, so defended it. So you only trade up and now Anand is a full piece up. He's a full piece up and Sameh, not a great start for Arijit. He is going to try and create some counter. But Abhi, I think this one might be the first game that might finish.
His knight has nowhere to go. His knight is saying, Sun raha hai na tu, ro raha hu main. Okay, sorry about this one. Sorry. Okay, let's
Tanya, did you see that tactic here where Vishy could have taken bishop knight 7 on Arijit's board? Vishy could have taken bishop before playing knight c3. Bishop at 7, there's a beautiful tactic.
Prachara, you're pointing this out. Tell us the line. Bishop at 7. Yes, Sami.
Bishop at 7, king at 7, and then knight g5, and I think followed by queen h5 would have been devastating.
And if the king goes back, then queen h5, and there are all these ideas of checkmate. And if not back, king g6, also very dangerous because white can go queen g4 here, putting a lot of pressure on the black king as well. So instead of that, he decided to actually go knight c3, but it's still winning because unke paas ek extra piece hai. Let's take a look at what team and with Manu Jain and Jordan Jain, what are they up to?
Okay, I can start
from the beginning, Sameh.
Yep. Okay. C4O English system.
This is the English opening. Sameh, jab tumne chess khelna shuru kiya tha, jaise when you were streaming pehle, C4 used to be your favorite move, right?
Yeah, jab maine chess khelna shuru kiya tha, basically yesterday, tab main C4 khelna bahut pasand karta tha because it always used to confuse the opponent. And here, Manu is not alone. His son is also playing. He's a very big fan of Vishy Anand. And it's a very, very big deal for him to be playing alongside his father to fight Vishy Anand. And let's see how it goes. Oh, bishop d6. Not a very good move, no, Parchura?
Yeah, I think he should have teleported on e7, I think. That would have been better. Because now his c8 bishop is... don't know where to develop that.
That's absolutely right. Because after the move that actually was chosen by Manu, the problem is that this d5 pawn, the d pawn can't move forward, opening up the bishop, Prachara, like you're mentioning. So completely agree that bishop e7 was the right square, but bishop d6, nothing has gone too wrong for him. Let's just go back to this position. After a3, what Vishy wants to do is he wants to start advancing a pawn storm on the queen's side. So b6 pe unhone b4 badhaya. And now the bishop comes to b2 and this is our live position. I would say that yes, I would prefer black's bishop on e7 so that you can go d5. But still, not too bad. A little better for white.
Yeah. Let's quickly have a look at Ananya's game because she is a very, very strong player. And she's been taking coaching from a GM. And this is official, I can tell you. Parchura can definitely give me more insight about that.
that's what I last heard. But I think it was 2500. So I don't know whether he was a GM or not. But his rating was definitely 2500. And the person is not known to me. So... I think she's going to do well. I think she's already come out flying. I think her position is pretty equal as well. What do you guys think?
I think that we are doing a great work, guys. Just keep donating more and more money and we can do more help to so many people. And that is, always remember, that is the main idea of this event. So please keep donating. And about the position, I can't tell you much. Tanya is the better expert there. So Tanya, please tell us what's happening.
Finally, Sameh, you admit. You know, I have to tell chat that, you know, nowadays what happens is earlier, like in the beginning, last year, aise when Sameh used to lose to me, he didn't really care. But now when he actually loses to me, he gets upset. He actually gets angry. And I always feel he like, has... is he forgetting?
Can you keep my anger issues for another stream? Not when Amir Khan is here and my mom is watching, please. So let's go back to Amir's game.
I think because of his competitive spirit, I think he's really improved. Yeah, Sameh has really improved because I played with him, I think, a year ago, and he was not that good. Now he's pretty good.
That time, though, you said you are very good. Next year, also, you'll say, last year I played, he was not good. Parchura,
are bhai, Makkan, I was doing Makkan. No, you're playing really good. I mean, for that time at that level, you're playing pretty good. Now you have come to another level.
Wow.
Oh, you know, guys, you're almost like a professional.
What happened in this game? It was so complicated.
Not only Samir is playing very good, Amir as well. After this, e takes d5, he took with the knight, and now after d4, he takes out his bishop to e6, defends the knight on d5. Yes, it gives up the bishop, and now, but still, the position is fine for black here. The problem is that Samir, he can't take this pawn on e5. It can lead to some unpleasant checks with queen h5. Yes, you have knight g6, but short castle, rook e1, bahut zyada pressure hai. So Amir actually decided that bishop e6, fe6, de5. Let me just bring up our board. He first decided to continue with development. He wanted to go queen e7 and he wanted to go long castle. After going short castle, unhone apni bhi development complete ki. And now look at this, Amir playing super aggressive. Look at these knights
wow,
on the center
a good
of
move.
The board. Attacking that queen on e2, attacking that pawn on c2. I have to say that Rishi's a pawn up, but Amir has full compensation here.
Yeah, yeah. And
absolutely, you're right, Tanya.
I mean, take a look at this. Samir, what happens if white goes queen d3?
Oh, very, very nice. Knight sacrifice, maybe?
Knight sacrifice? I'm not really sure what you mean by that, but I think knight b4 is the move that comes to my mind here, just hitting this pawn and this queen on d3, which can cause a lot of problems.
That's a knight sacrifice, right?
That's a queen sacrifice if you take that knight sacrifice.
No, not that. The knight on b4 will die, right?
Yeah.
How, Samir?
In 15-16 moves, you see.
Oh, right. About 15-16 moves, yes.
I'm like, Anand, I'm sure Anand will take it the way.
That is true. That is a knight sacrifice if you're playing against Anand.
Okay.
Knight d4. So Anand cannot go queen d3 because of knight b4, which Amir would have found for sure. Instead, Amir goes queen e4 because unko c2 pawn bhi defended rakhna hai. And now this knight on d4 is attacked. So I think... Oh, it's a little tricky for Amir to find that compensation to see. I think queen c5 is what I'm expecting him to play, attacking this bishop on c4 and defending the knight on d4.
I'm sure Amir had prepared some other opening and he just got thrown off in the opening itself. And it has led to such a complicated position with so many tactical opportunities that it might be difficult for Amir.
I think Amir is going.
He's a great actor, that's all I know.
No, I can attest to it. I think he's a positional player. And I think he's going to play knight f5 now. That's my prediction.
Yeah. Oh, Arijit Singh's position is looking very bad. His queen on f... on his queen is on, literally... Ki tum hi ho. Ab ho, bas tum hi ho. Is the queen on b4. Because nothing else is developed here.
Yeah, with the queen, exactly. It's like you're saying, it's saying was tum hi ho, but also it's telling the other pieces, agar tum saath ho, because none of them are, you know, with the queen.
Yeah, if the rook would be together with the queen, they would probably do something on the open e-file, but...
All right, so knight d5 played. Attacking the queen, Samir. Attacking knight c7. Prachura, knight f6 coming. This looks like Vishy is in the driving seat here and very difficult position for Arijit.
Yeah,
this would be the first game that would get over.
Yeah, this is going to be over very soon. Chahu main ya na.
Yeah, I mean, we would have... okay. So, I think it's pretty much lost from here.
You're talking about the Arijit game. Yeah, I agree.
It's Arijit
pretty
game,
much lost from here.
Yeah.
And as we can see that after the move, knight d5, Arijit played queen d6 on knight c7, fork aa chuka hai.
And now the rook is saying, Amar jai. Okay, I have to stop somewhere. I have to stop.
Are, that is not even his song, I think.
It was his song. It was his song, man.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. My bad.
Come on. Achha,
okay, my bad.
All right, look at this position, guys, what we have. Now, in this one, it looks like Vishy's again doing really well. Unke paas ek extra pawn hai. If we count the material, Vishy's got 7 pawns. Manu has got only 6 pawns. Vishy has got 2 bishops. And as we can see, it's an open position. This is definitely advantage Vishy, but it's far from over because Manu ke paas bhi activity hai. This bishop is quite strong. And look at this. The moment I say this bishop is very strong, Vishy makes the move bishop f3, just neutralizing this long diagonal ka bishop.
So many super chats. We have Rushabh Gandhiji. Thank you so much for the super chat, man. My father also super chat 2199. Please give me Google Pay. I will also super chat. I will directly transfer it. Why are you giving YouTube 30%, Papa? Yeah, come on, man.
No, that's so sweet of your parents. I think both of them gave in donation. That's super sweet, man.
This is the first sweet. Time they are proud of me, I think, you know. But anyway, yes, let's keep going.
You managed to get the shout out as we discussed.
Yeah,
that's great.
I was actually thinking about it last night only. How will I get it? Should I get it? Because my mom had asked for it. I had to only get it. But anyway, so we're looking at Ananya's game, which is...
And he was so sweet because Amir was like, please pray for me, you know, that I'm able to fight. So, auntie, you know what you have to do.
Okay, one more shout out also you got, mom. So please, more money now. Okay. So
I can attest to this. Amir sir is so humble. I've interacted with him many times for this event. Oh my God, so sweet. We can't even believe that he's a superstar of this country.
Super duper star.
Absolutely.
Okay, look at this. Now, you guys were mentioning ki Ananya ko koi grandmaster train kara or 2500 rated player, which is, for those of you who don't know, 2500 rating in chess is a level of a grandmaster. So she has a very strong trainer. And actually, I have to say that out of all the games we've seen, this is the toughest fight.
Exactly.
It's equal material. It's 7 pawns versus 7 pawns. Ananya's bishop on g7 is placed nicely on this diagonal. The only thing that she has to watch out for is this weak b6 pawn. Or Anand's bishop is attacking that pawn, so she needs to take care that she doesn't lose this pawn. But actually still a very balanced position for Ananya.
And let's not forget that she's playing at 5 a.m. or something, you know, where she is right now. It's morning. She woke up early in the morning to take on the beast, the legend, Vishwanathan Anand. So, you know, she has to be in her senses. She has to be, you know, probably she had some black coffee or something to get her into the alert mode right now. And she's doing very, very well. 23 moves and the position is equal, guys. The bar says it's equal. So let's see. Anything can happen here.
Anything can happen here. And definitely a tough one. Prashant, let's go back to Amir's position and let's see where we left it. So, sorry.
Chat is saying mouse slipper for some game. Which game is that? Mouse slip by Anand.
All of my games.
No, Anand's a mouse slipped.
Okay,
somewhere.
Let's take a look.
Which
so
game
this
is
one,
that?
You just get to that. So queen e4. Amir found that move that we were talking about, defending this knight and attacking the bishop. He played it. And after knight d2, comes back with the knight to c6. Still, a lot of compensation for that pawn that he has. Going to be an interesting match. But let's move on and see where the mouse slip happened that the chat
is
talking about. So in this one, Arijit is still, he just made the move bishop d7, unka ek rook. I think Anand is going to go for this rook. And after rook a8, he's just big material up. So this one is not the mouse slip, the manuk. Oh, it's it could be this one. No, it's not this one because here bishop d5. Let me just go back a little bit. So we left it here.
It is not accurate.
Okay, not accurate. So chat is just pranking us with that mouse slip. Bishop d4, b5 played. And we were talking about this position. Jahan pe Vishy ne ye bishop rakha apna. He's got an extra pawn and he's challenging Black's very active bishop on b7. a5, I love this move by Manu. You know, this is such a brilliant move because it creates a weakness on the queen side and it's really eyeing for some counterplay. And queen b3. Super nice move. So the d5 bishop is attacked if you take on a3, which is what he went for. But this is not a good idea, chat, now, because after bishop d5, Manu is just a piece down. He does have these pawns, but they're going to be blocked by the queen and bishop. And I think Vishy's extra piece is going to count in this one.
Yeah. And I think in this panel, utna bada fight nahi hua jitna last panel mein tha. However, the Ananya's board is still very strong. Let's have a look at this board.
All right, so queen d5 was the last move here. And now after this, rook c8 was played. A nice move by Ananya, placing it on this c-file, making sure ki white ka kabhi aise c5 kind of threats na hoye. And after rook c8, Anand going for an endgame. You know, I've seen this even in the last segment. If you notice, Samay Prachara, that You know, when he was not getting anything out of the opening and it was level, he knew that he could outplay these opponents in the end game. And that's exactly what he did against Sajid. He did it against Sudeep. He did it. He, you know, they had such a big fight in this opening and middle game. But in that end game, Anand is just too strong.
And Ananya refuses. Ananya says, no, I don't want to go to the end game. She refuses. I want to fight in the mid game. I want to create more complications. So this is a very exciting game. We'll come back to it, Tanya. Let's have a look at Aamir Khan versus Rishi Anand. What has happened there? Yahan pe dal khichdi ban gayi hai beech mein.
So after knight c6, c3 khela, Anand ne controlling the center squares, making sure ki wo knight wapas wahan nahi aata. And here, nice little move by Aamir, and I hope that he wants to go bishop g7, attacking this e5 pawn. Can also think about developing the bishop elsewhere. Not just that, let's not forget this queen on e4 is attacking this pawn on h7. So ye rook thoda tied down hai, but after the move g6, the rook is free to develop as well. Knight b3 attacking that queen. Queen went back. And I like Vishy how he's playing. He's playing energetically. He's playing aggressively. Now he's threatening to spoil the pawn structure, forcing Aamir into passivity here.
Wow.
Yeah, so, but knight b8 was a very good move, Tanya. I think Aamir avoided all the threats.
You're totally right about that, because now I'm seeing that knight ke paas aur koi ghar hi nahi tha, because imagine making a developing move jaise main pehle bol rahi thi, and look at this pawn structure. The king would be mega weak here. End up getting checkmated. Knight a5 coming in, putting pressure on this pawn. A queen coming in from c4 to a6. So actually you have a really good point, Prachura, that yes, it's an ugly move, but it's actually a strong move, because after knight b8 he makes sure ki unka pawn structure kharab nahi hota.
Yeah. And now,
absolutely, I think now followed by c6 and knight 7, I think his position will become much better.
Interesting.
That's a good way to continue.
I think now again, in this round, Vishy is playing so many boards where he's completely winning. So his strategy might be to completely just win over there, like in the board against Arijit. Let's have a look. Is he almost winning over there? Is the game over?
And he plays a6, not c6, but also a nice move, hitting that bishop. Before we move on to this one, let's do like quick side bets, guys. Let's just take our quick evaluation of this position and do a quick tour. Prachura, Same, what do you think about this position?
I think Aamir will create some more complications, because he's like a creative genius. You know, he's a very creative mind. Even in his movies, he does very few movies, but when he does, he comes up so, you know,
great
movies, some great ideas. So like we see knight b8 and all these ideas, this shows creativity. So this is this game will get a little complicated, is what I feel.
Absolutely. I think Ananya's and Aamir's game will last the longest, and there'll be a close fight between these two games.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look at Arijit's game.
Oh my god.
And this is not looking good. So still Anand is not rushing with picking up that exchange. He's going to do it. He's basically saying ki abhi main kabhi bhi maar sakta hun mein se ek rook, because it's still under fork. So no rush with that. And I think this, we all can agree, is Anand's game, and it should end soon.
Yeah. I mean, what is, like, is there any hope for Arijit in this position at all? Is there? No?
Only if Vishy makes a huge blunder.
Yeah, I think what happened in the last segment, not only is he very too strong to make a blunder, but in general, I think he is going for blood on every board in this one.
Yeah, look, sare pieces aa rahe hain aage, knight aa gaya hai, queen aa gayi hai, matlab it's like gone.
Domination.
But yeah,
tough fight, tough game for Arijit to create something. Let's see Manu's position.
I just have to... Arijit did just show a charity fundraiser just 2-3 years back, and he just came onto this. It's so sweet of him to do this after doing such a big fundraiser. Hats off to him.
Yeah.
He's coming to back-to-back fundraisers. That's really good.
That's so cool. And guys, please donate. Please subscribe to this channel. There'll be more events here. Okay, in Arijit Singh's position, we've moved to Manuji's game.
Arijit was, Samir, because Arijit's position, I think we saw it. We saw that he's losing big material here. And Anand, knight e5, very nice move, creating a threat on this bishop on d7. Bahut sare pieces hanging hai, and it's going to be a tough one for Arijit.
Yeah.
And absolutely. The story is the same for Manu as well, I think. But isme thoda compensation hai because Anand has an extra piece. He has this extra bishop if we calculate the number of pieces on the board. But on the other hand, Manu has advanced his pawns to b4, a3. So Anand has to make sure ki these pawns don't go forward. But look at this nice blockade he set up. The rook on b1, the queen on d3. Make sure that black is not able to push b3 because then the pawn will not survive. Also, a2 is stopped because of the queen on d5. So Anand has put his pieces in a way that black's pawns can't move forward anymore.
Yeah, yeah. So is it safe to say that Ananya's board is the only one which has a significant chance right now?
Yeah, I think that's the only game which is probably equal right now. Rest all the boards, I think Vishy is slightly better. And I think in Manu's game as well, those two pawns, that can be a slight worry. But I think with the move queen c4, I think he's going to lose that b4 pawn now as well. So that might be the next game to finish as well. We don't know.
Mm-hmm. Very nice point. So Anand just made the move queen c4, attacking that pawn on b4. And Prachura, you're pointing out that black has no good way of actually defending it. But he needs to be a little careful because, for example, here if you go queen b4, rook c1 check.
आप लोगों का क्या सीन है मैं ऐसे देखने आया हूँ.
कौन है? I can hear someone. अरे अरिजीत जी आए. अरिजीत जी की पोजीशन का क्या हुआ?
Arijit has come back to Zoom to check out how other people are That's doing, crazy. How the other players are doing.
What's happening here?
I love it.
You're doing great, bhai. You're doing great.
So
keep playing, sir.
So just needs to be careful coming back to this position. Rook c8. Anand can't fall for this trap. Queen b4. Thoda careful hona hoga. Rook c1 check. King hatana hoga because if you take the rook, you lose the queen. And if you go king h2, you end up losing the rook. So you can't pick up the pawn immediately with the queen. And I wonder if Anand decides to pick it up with the rook. He decides to pick it up with the rook. He goes for rook b4. And the idea is that if you take rook c4, then rook b8 comes in with a check. So rook b4, Manu made the move queen a8. And he wants to go a2 and he wants to go a1. And that's the dream. But Anand shatters all of them with the move rook a4, making sure this pawn doesn't go anywhere. And he's just winning all the pawns. He wins the whole house with this move.
I wonder how Amir is doing right now because his position was very interesting. Can we go back to where it was?
Yeah. Oh, looks like he's drawing an exchange.
But how did he come here, Tanya? Can you show us?
Let's go back. And this was where we left it last. And after c3, g6, we were talking about this move and how knight b8, Amir found this really nice way to keep everything under control. Pushed that bishop back, attacked it, pushed it back. Advance on h5, but this move, you know, pawn moves. Samir, you have to be so careful about it. Queen g6 is just hanging. He loses the second pawn in the game, develops the bishop on g7. And this was the turning point because now with this queen on g6, Anand also gets bishop g5 in. And
g5.
That's a skewer on the board. If the queen moves, then you lose the rook. And here, Amir trying to create play with knight f4. A nice little tactical move.
This is the creativity. You know, it's like, ab nahi ho raha hai position mein, toh complicate karo, kuch create karo. That is what he's doing. I'm sure this would have definitely worked against like a player like me. Ki main confused, ab kya karun main?
Ab definitely, yeah. Bullet mein toh tu pakka sochta is position mein. Ki hua kya?
Yeah, wo hua kya toh main tabhi sochta ki agar Amir mein saath khelte toh. First of all, usi mein ho jata. Ki hua kya? Position mein toh baad mein aate hum. But yeah,
that is still a pretty good try.
But unfortunately, the drawback of the move knight f4 is that it's undefended. So Anand just goes on to pick up the knight.
Quote hai na ki complicate the game and opponent will blunder. Uske aage hona chahiye, but don't do it when opponent is Vishwanathan Anand.
But I think things are already quite bad for black in this position because he lost those two pawns. But yeah, now
bishop e6. Tanya is threatening bishop e6.
Needs to be so careful. So let's just show that, for example, if black tries to make a move like rook f8, attacking the bishop, Samay is pointing out that bishop e6 actually wins the queen. So Amir needs to spot this threat and he needs to fight this threat. How is he
I think he has to play rook e8, rook d8. That's
even
the only way.
Then you can go bishop e6 because you've got the knight and the queen both attacking e6.
What happens if you capture the knight first?
Also very strong, a knight, then, you're saying.
I'm saying knight.
I think he can move his queen. I think he can move his queen to e7. That would be a decent
but
move.
But you still lose so much material in this position. You mean queen e7
absolutely.
Instead of rook e8. You mean here.
Yeah. Absolutely.
But also big trouble here because the e6 pawn falls. This rook is hanging. The bishop is hanging. This is falling apart for black.
Yeah.
And
damn
he plays bishop c4. Such a strong move by Anand. Because you know, he could have gotten greedy here and picked up the e6 pawn because that was hanging anyway. But instead, he played the mega strong bishop c4, putting that... And Ahmed finds it. He finds the only way to not lose the queen and the game on the spot. He moves the queen to e8 and I think this attacks the queen. But unfortunately, it loses the e6 pawn. And also here, Anand could have also probably picked up this bishop on g7. But instead, he says he'll go into this endgame. Amir is going to recapture this queen with either of the rook and then e6 pawn will fall as well.
But I'm so really, really surprised by Amir's opening play. Like the way he played that d5 move, it was fantastic. But anyway, we'll come back to Arjit Singh's game. And what is happening here?
Anand's still a piece up, so still a bad position for Arjit.
Nikhil, jinne 50,000 rupees ka super chat kiya hai, in my ear, he whispered, Niranjan ji, can you tell me his full name? So we'll give him a nice shout out. Oh, Nikhil Kamath, of course. Guys, we just saw him play amazing chess. And thank you so much for donating so much money for this great cause.
Thank you so much, Nikhil. Thank you so much, not only for the donation, yeah, in a big way, but also for the entertaining chess that you played. Nikhil's the only player who actually won today. You know, even though, yes, Anand resigned that game, Sameh Prachara, where he could have flagged Nikhil probably, but that quality of that play by Nikhil, position-wise, he was better. He was winning at that position, at that point.
It was pretty good, I think. It was a great gesture by Vishy to resign. I mean, I was not on the stream that time. So, amazing. I would have never thought. He's such a gentleman. Yes, such a gentleman.
And Nikhil is also like so humble, no? He came and he said, no, I'm fine. I don't play chess. And then he played amazing. He won. And even then he was like, no, that's cool. He's such a humble guy. And we rarely see such amazing, humble people in the world. So, whenever we see them, my heart melts and I feel very, very good. So, thank you so much. And you also donated so much money for this great cause. It'll feed so many children who are underprivileged and who we can help. So, guys, please keep donating. The link is below. On UPI, you can donate. And we are now looking at Manu's game against... Yeah, we are, right? That's what we are
on. Yes, we're on Manu's game and we left it here. So, Rook B4 and Anand went on to just gobble up both these pawns. And this is the position now, Rook A7. Do you see what's going on here?
Once the queen moves.
Yes, let's see.
Can you guess the move?
C6.
It's mate in two.
The chat get it?
Yeah, I think this will get over really soon.
Queen F7 is the problem. And after King H8, Queen G7 would be checkmate. And Rook A7, Hamari live position ye hai. The problem is that the queen can't go anywhere where it can defend the F7 pawn. Queen F3 is the move you want to make, but this G pawn is controlling that square. So you can't keep the pawn defended.
The only move is to take the rook with the queen, maybe?
That's a good defensive move, but you do lose the queen in that case and eventually the game.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, he went for Rook B1.
He played the move Rook B1. So, Sameh, in another way, he gave up the queen. But the result, I don't think, is going to change. Now, after Rook B7, Anand is just going to pick up the A3 pawn as well. He has a queen and a bishop versus rook. That's too much of a material advantage.
I'm so happy for Manu's son. You know, he must be so happy that he's playing one of his idols, one of the people that he respects the most. And he's the most big fan of Vishy Anand. So, it is a story that he'll tell his friends in school and he'll get all the clout in this with his classmate that I played Anand. Who are you playing? I played Vishwanathan Anand. So, I'm sure it's a great day for his son. And so many people are donating and that's the real win over here. So, we are now looking at... Yes, Tanya ji.
No, go on, Sam.
No, I was just saying that we are looking at Anand's game and dheere dheere aap dekho, Vishy sir has converted. Thoda aaya hai unke paas kafi advantage.
And Ananya is really short on time as well.
Oh. she's down to 6.5 minutes. So we left it here where lag raha tha ki Ananya's position is totally fine. And like we can see, it's quite balanced actually, materially. No big weaknesses. And now she's just playing, moving pieces around. Meanwhile, Anand also improving the pieces. He's gotten all his three major pieces on the D-file. And now he goes for queen e4. So saying that your queen on c7 can't move because the pawn on e7 is attacked. But he also has a very, very sly idea. He's also threatening a move like bishop g5 with a double attack on e7 and h4. Not just that, he's threatening a move like g5. And this h4 pawn actually becomes a big weakness. So it's funny ki the whole game was played on the queen side with all these pieces. But actually, Ananya is going to end up losing a pawn on the king side. And g5, he goes for it. The h pawn falls, and with that, Anand gets the advantage because he's a pawn up.
Yeah, yeah. And good, we have so much. Well. Shashank Kashiji, thank you so much. Rushabh Gandhiji, again, thank you so much. UPI is not working this day. Maybe it has got flooded right now with so many super chats. Is it working? Okay. In my ear, the today's OBS Lord has whispered that
it is working. So please try to donate via UPI. Thank you.
Okay. How is. Amir was in the end game. What happened then?
So he traded the queens where we left it last time. And now the e6 pawn falls. The bishop on g7 is hanging. So Amir, of course, spots that, but he doesn't.
Oh.
After knight d7, the bishop falls.
I mean, it's so exhausting also to play against Vishy Anand. This... And when Vishy decides to attack, like this game, he's just like, chalo, let me attack now.
Yeah, and also, you know, they're playing online for the first time. So it's very different when you're used to playing on the normal chessboard and then moving on to play online. It's totally different.
That's very true. You know, I have first-hand experience of this, Tanya. When I was playing 2D, I used to have blunders in 2D. But when I was playing 3D, I used to have blunders in 3D.
How does one resign?
How does one resign?
There is a switch called resign. Like if you
resign. मैं तो कब से ढूंढ रहा हूँ रिजाइन ही नहीं हो रहा हूँ मैं अच्छा तो दिख नहीं रहा है किधर से रिजाइन करूँ ये तो अटक गया अपन यार गेम में
मुझे तो मजा ही आ रहा है
सर फाइट टिल द एंड सर फाइट टिल द एंड
अच्छा
फाइट
टिल द एंड
ओके ओके
हाँ तुम्हें घोड़ा हटाए थे नहीं
अच्छा दूसरे का बोर्ड
कैसे दूसरे का बोर्ड
क्योंकि मेरा बोर्ड देख के फायदा ही नहीं
है मेरा बोर्ड देख के फायदा ही नहीं
है किसे यार रिजाइन कराओ यार किस तरह
रिजाइन कराओ यार किस तरह
ऑर्डर जोन रिजाइन
ऑर्डर जोन रिजाइन
या
हो गया
वहां पे एक फ्लैग होगा हमें सर राइट में पर आप उस पे मत क्लिक करें ना आपके लिए ना एंटर
क्या रह गया मैं एंटर क्या करूं
मतलब लोग डोनेट कर रहे हैं जब तक आप खेल रहे हो
अच्छा करेक्ट करेक्ट लोग डोनेट कर रहे हैं
Amir has to take one for the team.
How do we donate? Do we have a link?
नहीं यार खत्म हो गया गेम अभी मैं क्या करूँ?
Yeah,
fantastic. Please send us the link.
हरिजीत तेरा क्या चल रहा है
मेरा वही है मतलब बैठा हूँ I don't know what to do.
गया मेरा रुक भी गया ऐसे क्या होता है?
ये चीज इस down to 7 seconds उन्हें move चलनी है उन्हें move चलनी है.
Oh. Oh okay. So we have the first results. First result of the day.
कैसे बताएं?
इसका time आ गया आप लोग समझा करो.
अच्छा मेरा तो time ही गया. ना ही मेरे. Very good.
चलो.
Oh wow and. So Amir also decides to resign in this position.
अच्छा mistakes too बता रहा है कौन से mistakes?
He's analyzing his game, Amir.
First mistake was to resign, sir.
Isn't it amazing कि how Amir wants to actually analyze the game immediately after finishing it?
Absolutely.
How do I watch the boards?
Posted in the chat for you.
अच्छा इधर हाँ ये लाइव में दिख रहा है।
So On Very Zoom good. Chat, you can see it as well.
You know, in the start only, I made a mistake.
पर आपने ओपनिंग बहुत ही बढ़िया खेली थी मतलब ओ
नहीं मेरे को पॉन अप करना चाहिए था मैंने वो नाइट अप नहीं करना चाहिए मैंने उसको नाइट को घुसने नहीं देना चाहिए तो नाइट घुस गया
अच्छा अमित सर कैन यू कम टू गूगल मीट एंड टॉक आप यहां पे म्यूट कर लो ताकि ना इनको आपकी आवाज ना आए
तो मैं कैसे आऊं
मैं आपको लिंक भेजता हूं
किधर भेजोगे
गूगल Zoom चैट आप उस पे वीडियो मत ऑन करना उस पे बस आप ऑडियो में आ जाओ यहां पे आप म्यूट कर लीजिए
Like meanwhile, Samay, Ananya is still fighting and how? Because look at this position now. She's down 2 pawns, but Anand's king is a little exposed here. She needs to move the queen away. She needs to move the queen away and then start doubling up on the e-file. We're going to have Amir with us very soon also to commentate on the games and give us his thoughts. She goes queen c8, which is also a good move. She steps away from the queen, but the problem with this key, rook on b8 gets a little stuck on b8 and you really want to bring it into the game but you can't right now because of queen c8 but still not easy for Vishy to convert this because he has to be careful about his own king and finally Manu also resigned in this position wow this he got checkmated let's quickly see how that happened after
oh yeah.
We do have Amir with us
Can he hear us? Can
you hear me? Yeah, we can hear you, Amir. Can you hear us?
No, I think we have to be on.
Can you hear us now?
Now I can hear you. Now I can. You were all muted for some reason.
Yeah, Tanya, can you come to Google Meet? We are doing like 10 अलग-अलग जगह से हमने वॉइस लिया है. But yes, sir, how was the experience? मतलब आपने ओपनिंग में वो D5 कैसे ढूंढा?
कौन सा D5? वो जो पॉन.
I can see the board.
Okay, so I've sent the link on the chat.
वो link आपको Google Meet पे आ गया होगा. You can see the game over there. So
ये
हाँ दिख रहा है pop again.
आप click करो एक बारी. It should open up.
क्या click करो?
Google Meet के अंदर Google Meet के chat में.
Meet के
Sign up. बोल रहे हैं sign up to start playing. It's free.
आप रहने दीजिए. हम आपसे ऐसे ही बात करते हैं कि आप बताइए. Like this after the opening, you were fine actually. You know, हम लोग बाहर देख रहे थे and this B5 player was very fine. Tanya, when did it start tumbling?
It's so Amir, you have the game in front of you, no? You do have the game in front of you.
Yeah.
Best.
So let's go to move 5.
One second. I'm first have to click out of this thing. Move 5. How do you move 5? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 5. Correct.
So when Anand took your pawn on D5.
Yeah.
Actually, this move D5, this fourth move, jo aapne D5 chali hai, it's the only move in Black's position, and it's a very strong move. We were all very impressed that you played this.
Yeah, but how should I have followed up with that?
So after E takes D5, like the theoretical, the line goes, you go knight A5. You don't take on D5 so quickly.
You don't take on. So D5. I didn't.
So.
Yes, sir. You took on D5.
I should not have taken on D5. I was wondering.
Yeah.
But still, you played very well after this. I mean, you know, you created your play and you developed your pieces, and it was all fine. And one more moment that we thought that, you know, you've really created some trouble if you just come to move 10. And here you played knight B4. This was amazing.
Which one?
Move 10. Aapne jo 10th move chali.
Correct.
आपको क्या लग रहा था अपनी पोजीशन के बारे में एट दिस पॉइंट?
एक सेकंड ना, मैं 9th पे जाता हूं, फिर जाता हूं। पहले मैंने 9th पे कासिल किया,
हां फिर 10th मूव पे एनडी फोर सर,
फिर हां ये मूव, बिकॉज़ आई वांटेड टू, मैं कैसे देखूं ठीक से,
क्लिक ऑन दैट मूव सर,
क्लिक ऑन दिस। हां सो आई प्लेड माय नाइट एंड देन ही ब्रॉट हिज क्वीन डाउन देयर।
हां जी,
सो आई थॉट दैट, अभी ऋषि तो कभी ऐसा करेगा नहीं, लेकिन मुझे लगा थोड़ा प्रेशर पे क्वीन डालता हूं, कभी गलती से उसने पॉन छोड़ दिया तो मैं खा लाऊंगा उसका। तो मेरे पास दो लाइन खुले थे, लेकिन उसने मेरे को वो दो लाइन का एडवांटेज लेने नहीं दिया।
और आपने कोशिश की थी, because you wanted to bring your bishop out and put your rook on f8 also. Like you really wanted to develop your pieces.
Suppose when he did this, what should I have? What did I do after that?
So all this was fine. You played queen c5, which was correct. And I think the only move that I feel कि आपने थोड़ा जल्दी like this knight on d4. So are you on move move 12?
One second, move 12 now.
कुछ समझ नहीं आती क्या करे, मतलब
But you know, Amir, it's amazing what you say that this rook on d8 on the open file, two open files, and you wanted to make use of that. It gives me the impression that you like to play attacking chess. Do you think you're more of an attacking player or more of a positional player?
No, I'm an very attacking player, but today I was trying to last long, so I was not playing my natural game. What happens is I never play my natural game. Twice I played him, twice I feel that I better try and last as long as I possibly can. Once I should just try and play my natural game and get blasted early, but at least I'll play my natural game. So, he didn't give me a chance because I was just one move behind. I was trying to ghuso on those files, but he didn't let me. He didn't let me. He kept me busy after that.
And I think that one move behind was this moment jab aapne knight wapas liya. Like, you know, you would have just developed the bishop and got your rook out. I think you would have made the most of your chances.
When you're playing against legend, it's the finest things, like even one move here and there and then
you're gone.
That's it, sir. Yeah.
And guys, as we're talking about this, Ananya is still fighting with 2 minutes on the clock against Vishi.
Wow. How is the game going? Yeah? How is Arichi's game gone?
Arichi's sir ki game to chali gayi.
Acha. And what about apna
Manu? Manu's game also done.
Only Ananya is left now with 2 minutes on her clock.
And she's really fighting. Like the position, it was level for a long time. Finally, with these two pawns, and he's marching with his king. Look at his king on h5. I don't know if Amir can see the live board.
How do I see this?
जहाँ पे आपकी game है ना?
I'll go live.
आप YouTube पे देख लोगे.
YouTube में देखो. If he's using his knight, that means they're obviously into endgame and. If he's using his king, you said.
Yeah, it's king. King queen versus king queen.
That's but the crazy queen, part. The queen.
Yeah. Queens are still there, sir.
Oh.
But look at this king on h5. How safe it is. There are no checks on the board, and the point is that the only check that Ananya had, and very smartly, she didn't play queen d1 check because after king h6. Black will start getting checkmated. Queen e8 RI, queen h7 RI. So queen d1 check was a bad move, and Ananya saw that and sidesteps with king h8.
एक तो ये queen की endgame ना, it's so complicated. ऐसा कुछ कहते ना तानिया, ये तो chess player है, that chess में चार part होते हैं, opening, mid game. अगर आ गए तो queen endgame and then endgame. Because queen endgame में जो normal में होता है कि check दे दो, वो काम ही नहीं करता. You can never understand what's happening in the queen endgame.
Absolutely. But I mean, you're totally right about that. And Anand has two pawns up. Ananya has to play a little fast. She has a minute and 40 seconds, but she's really put up an amazing fight. going to be interesting to see how much she holds on with this position and how difficult she makes Anand to be able to convert here. Queen g6 check, forcing Anand's king to go back, forcing king g4 here.
अमित सर आप इतना चेस खेलते हो, आई एम श्योर आप अपने मूवी के शूट के बीच में भी चेस खेलते होगे। कभी ऐसा हुआ है किसी मूवी किसी आपके को-स्टार ने आपको एकदम सरप्राइज कर दिया अपने चेस खेल से, जैसे आज हम हो गए थे साजिद जी से?
नहीं, मुझे एक्चुअली सरप्राइज किया दो बच्चों ने। एक मैं लगान की शूटिंग कर रहा था कच्छ में, और एक दिन मेरे सेट पे कोई लड़की आई अपने फादर के साथ, छोटी सी लड़की। उसने उस फादर ने बोला ये मेरी बच्ची चेस खेलती है, आपके साथ चेस खेलना चाहती है। मैंने सोचा यार ये 5-6 साल की लड़की है, मैं क्या चेस खेलूंगा। अब वो छोटी सी थी, उसका शी वाज फीलिंग बैड, सो ऐसे चलो खेल लेते हैं एक छोटा सा गेम खेल लेते हैं। शी ट्रैश मी सो बैडली, इतनी बड़ा मुझे हराया उसने। तो मैंने बोला यार ये कौन है लड़की। तो फिर मुझे वो फादर ने बताया कि ये कुछ स्टेट चैंपियन है, पता नहीं क्या है, नंबर 9 पता नहीं क्या होता है। आई थिंक वो 10-12 साल की थी, सॉरी सॉरी। Yeah, and then I was similarly, I played against another boy, I forget his name now. He was a small boy, about 6 years old. He was literally 6 years old. His feet were all on the ground. Jo kursi pe baitha tha wo, uske feet hang ho rahe, dangle ho rahe the. Aur wo bhi aise shooting pe aaya tha mujhse milne ke liye, and I said chalo I'll play, and within 10 minutes he had mated me. So I was like, okay, no, I have to play. Thoda dhyan se khelna hai. Oh, damn. I lasted a little bit longer, not much longer.
अगली शूटिंग आपके जहां भी हो,
ये तो सुनो, इसका हाइलाइट अभी तक खत्म नहीं हुआ है। तो मैंने उसको कि भाई मैं आपके साथ सीरियसली खेलना चाह रहा हूं, तो नेक्स्ट व्हेन आर यू कमिंग टू बॉम्बे। सो 3 मंथ्स लेटर वी सेट अप अ चेस मैच। आई मेड श्योर आई वाज नॉट शूटिंग, इट वाज अ संडे। ही केम होम विद हिज मदर, वी सेट अप अ चेस बोर्ड। द गेम लास्टेड 3 आवर्स, 3.5 आवर्स। ओह, एंड आई हैड हिज डिफेंस, आई हैड ब्रोकन कंप्लीटली, एंड आई हैड घुसोड इनसाइड। व्हाट हैपेंड, रिएक्टिंग टू समथिंग?
No, sorry. Ananya just made a blunder. She was playing so well, Amit. She just blundered a queen. But she was just playing so well.
I think the game is over now.
But please continue.
So I played that game, lasted 3.5 hours. And there was one point in the game, by then my head was completely jammed, you know, I couldn't think anymore. It had become a very complicated situation. I was trying to think moves ahead. I had one of two options. And I was trying to think beyond the seventh, eighth move, and I couldn't. My brain was jammed. So I said, listen, I think I'm close to winning. I don't think either move chances are, I'm going to win this game. So I played one move. The moment I played that move, he said, you've lost.
Wow.
And he told me, if you had played the other move, you would have won. And exactly, I lost after that. Then he retraced and he said, if you had played this move, then this is how I was losing. And after that game, he told me, you've improved. He was 8-9 years old. He said, your game has improved. So but I said, thank you.
But guys, this is why Amir sir is Amir sir. He lost once, twice, and still he came back. He was so determined.
Yeah, to still do well, that is hats off to you, sir.
Not a lot of people do that, actually. You're a definite fighter.
You know, I've never really learned chess from a teacher, like openings and middle game. I've been a person who's just like my grandmother.
Wow, let's get them on, because this is an amazing moment. Amir, you have to see this position, what happened. You will love this, because at the end,
Tanya, can you?
Because I didn't know where to check. So
everybody move to Zoom, mute on Google Meet.
One second.
Tanya, we'll go to Zoom.
We go to Zoom.
Yeah, you're on mute.
I'm not mute.
Hello and welcome back. Yeah, guys, what a fight, Ananya. You fought till the end.
Oh my god, Anand, what, Queenie 8, what a brilliant move at the end, yaar.
Yeah, maybe I should have. I mean, it's too good not to be rewarded, but.
I missed that last. I didn't see any of the game. So what happened at the end? Tell me, Ananya.
Can you see it?
The live board?
Yeah, let's see the live board.
Yeah, just go on the stream. You'll see the live board.
Yeah.
How to do that?
Yeah, exactly. How to do that?
YouTube ka link page do. Samay, can you send the link?
I don't know. Maybe I can link share my screen or someone can share. Can you share your screen, Tanya?
Yeah, I'll just share.
I'm watching it on that this thing on the YouTube now.
Is
मैंने Zoom चैट पे रखा है अने कुछ शेयर द स्क्रीन तो उनका OBS निरंजन जी कह रहे हैं पूरा मैसेज आएगा सो आई हैव जस्ट सेंड अमित जी आई हैव सेंड ऑन Zoom चैट जो भी आपके साथ जो आपको हेल्प कर रहे हैं दे कैन जस्ट क्लिक ऑन द लिंक एंड यू विल सी द गेम
वेट इज इट लाइव ओवर
नो वी आर स्टिल लाइव
and we have to show this moment yeah this Queenie 8 it was mind blowing you were watching it and I mean yeah, just amazing
guys how do I because I've gone into chess.com but it says start up to start playing it's free or something
I was login kar lo wahan pe top left pe login hoga
oh login
okay I have also
Arijit sir
haan ji
how was the experience kya kiya aapne ye
it was very very good man bahut maza aa raha tha main to dekh raha tha ki kaise how I get trapped I was waiting for that
yeah well you didn't pay attention for a second because I'm attacking your bishop and you could actually go back with your bishop to d6
Yeah,
and that's a normal position.
I think it's about the flow. I don't think I have that much of patience to totally, be into the game. I lost it there, I guess.
Arijit, you still did really good, huh? That was pretty good.
Yeah, I tried. It was fun. It was really.
Manu
really
was also fighting, but then towards the end. Vishy sir just dropped those two pawns from promoting and there was no more hope. Meanwhile, Amirji, have you figured out how to see the game? And everybody else, I have sent
now,
a link.
Now I can...
I don't know how to see the game.
Where to see the matches?
Zoom chat pe maine ek link bheja hai. Aap us pe click kar doge.
Chess.com, this live 173317422121, this one. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Clicking on that.
The video of use my toilet.
I can share my screen.
Sure,
I can't.
Something has opened. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Now I can see. Yes.
Yeah. Oh.
Okay, so tell me about it.
So here, she puts her queen on pre.
She puts her queen, where does she put it? Right on?
Yeah. On e8.
Eight. Okay, she puts it there. Then?
And if I capture, it's stalemate.
Correct.
Because no moves left.
Yeah.
In fact, it was a mistake to take this pawn because as long as I don't take it, there is no stalemate ever.
Right.
Because the pawn will always be able to move here.
Correct.
I got the arrow right, I think it's...
Yeah, also I'm just
going to I have to be on an analysis board.
Show it for our audience.
But after that, it was fantastic to do that. Here, it's actually risky for me because my king can get mated with the check on a light square. So I have to... go like this and
what move number are you on, Vishy?
I'm on move 68.
Yeah, that's where she picked basically, g6.
Yeah, and then I went g6 check instead, yeah.
And what did you do after this?
I gave a check.
You give a check. Okay. Right.
And now the pawn is pinned, so the king has to move and then I can take the queen and it's mate.
Right, it's all over.
No, but it's just amazing. Normally in chess, very rarely you get a chance to have a stalemate problem like this. So very beautiful.
That was a great finish to the game, sir.
Nice one. Yeah. So how do I come back to Zoom? Yeah. Okay. Got it. That is nice. Yeah. Really nice. Yeah, Ananya.
Yeah,
I wish
nice.
I could see the game. I'll probably catch it later on.
Yeah, actually, I'll have to see all the games. After this is done.
It'll be fun. But I made a mess of it, yeah, Vishy. Very soon in the game.
Yeah, no, I thought I should play some line where... actually, you have to know a lot of theory in this line. So you were unlucky in your selection. You have to know... I mean, you have to know exactly how to get compensation for that pawn.
Yeah. Actually, I was... I should have put my last pawn. What do you call it? I am not familiar with the ABCD. The last pawn, I should have moved it up. So your knight couldn't have moved up.
Yeah, D6, sir. Are you talking about D6?
Yeah, I would have preferred to put my pawn up.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that have been safer?
Instead of, at which moment?
Instead of knight of six.
Instead of knight of six, yes, you can do D6.
Yeah, I should have done that last pawn up and then put the knight.
Yeah.
Hey, Ranjan, can we have the board as well?
Actually, one of these days, I'm going to try and get some chess lessons here because I've never really learned with it, you know. So I don't really know openings well. I play, my grandmother taught me, as I told you. So I play just with my native intelligence and no real training. But one day, I will.
I call my mom.
Once you make a movie as a chess player, I think you'll do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, he'll get into the role and that's it.
Yeah, and then he'll do it.
Yeah.
Guys,
how wonderful to play with you, Vishi. I mean, it was such a lovely experience playing with you always and seeing you.
Yeah, same.
Nice of you to agree with all of us here.
It was wonderful.
Vishi sir was very kind to us. He allowed us to play for at least
15 minutes. Yeah, 100%. No doubt about it.
There were some nice tactics in your game. Can you allow me to share my screen? Then I can just show them what I'm talking about.
Yeah. I'd like to see that.
Who's the host?
Same. I'm not sure if on Zoom. I can show it to the audience. If you can just tell me the game and the move number.
So Manu's game.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, I'm tired.
after finding a move like Queen E8, I can completely understand that. That's a beautiful.
So if you go to move 22 or so.
Yes.
I mean, I can play Queen C4.
How do I see it?
Yeah, same here. How do I see it?
On YouTube, if you go to chess.com India. I just need a link.
The whole game is gone because I should do it in the analysis board. But anyway.
On YouTube. Okay.
22, you went, he went rook b1 and you went, he went rook
b1. B4, I went h3.
Yes.
Now he probably should have tried. I mean, it is lost. He can go rook c8 and then I go queen a5 again. I have to do it this way.
To win these pawns.
Yes.
Yeah, queen a5 is also really nice because you stop a2 and you attack b4. And also h3 was a very nice move because you can't start winning these pawns before you play that because rook c8, rook c1 are all back rank ideas then.
I mean, it's safety. I can go queen c4 instead of h3, but then on the next move, I'll have to go queen f1 or something, which is very unpleasant.
Right, right.
So I prefer to do it this way so that my queen can stay on a dominant square like a5. But that was interesting. Unfortunately, I won a pawn very quickly and then it's always very difficult to come back from that in this kind of position. So I also have the two bishops and it's very nice.
But you know, Manu, you sacrificed this piece and then you managed to create a lot of initiatives by advancing your pawns up to b4, a3. It didn't look so risky, but a really nicely created compensation there by Manu.
And I think the big, the worst moment came when I had to sacrifice my queen. There was no other option.
Let me pull that up. That was right.
Actually, here. I did not see rook f1.
Mm.
Because it's quite unpleasant to meet a move like rook f1 suddenly. And I assume I'm winning after f3, but you don't really feel like getting into that. And then I remembered that I had rook a7, which is a threat in general. And luckily it works here because if you move your queen, I give you a mate. So
that's actually a really nice.
But rook f1 was resourceful.
Very resourceful because queen a3, which was the first feeling you pick up the pawn after rook f2, there's a lot of...
I can still play e4, but you know, who wants to go down that road?
Absolutely.
But actually, also Ananya, there are about 6 or 7 moves in that queen ending that you're hanging on very accurately.
Well done.
Yeah. Yeah, well done on that. But...
But you know, we were all feeling that Ananya, your game was quite level for a while. Anand, where do you think was the turning point in this game where you felt that things went a little wrong?
I was happy when I saw h4.
Hmm.
Because after, by the way, when I played f3, you can actually go to h3 with your queen. It's very unpleasant. And you're probably still fine there.
Sorry, can you tell me the move number?
I missed that for a second.
I got myself into little 6 and then I tried to get out of it, and then the stalemate happened, but then I didn't see the pawn push. But I gave it my best. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
So move 26, Tanya.
Like, sorry?
Yeah.
No, I'm telling Tanya it's move 26, 27. After f3, she could go queen h3, and I can't win that pawn. Mm. But once I play g4, then your pawn is on a dark square, so I can take it in some future date, as happened in the game. So,
yeah.
Arijit, don't worry. I'm also as lost as you.
No. I'm looking because there are delays in the bandwidth.
Oh.
What I'm looking here is basically there is a microsecond delay in the live thing. I'm trying to figure out. Trying to match.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. There's so many good comments, and everyone's donated so much money, guys. Please keep donating. Mm-hmm. Amisha, there's a lot of people asking in the chat. Now I can't, hire anymore. So many people are asking this question. Can I ask you this question?
Yeah. What is the question?
Question is, let's say if there's an amazing biopic about Vishy Anand, would you take the lead role?
Is that a question? That's one of the easiest questions to answer.
That's awesome.
It would be not only an honor and pleasure to play Vishy, but it would be highly exciting to get into his mind, because when I'm playing a character and, I try to understand the person's mind, and Vishy being a real person, I would, obviously spend a lot of time with him to understand his mind and how his mind works. Mm. Then I would understand from his wife and his family how his mind works. And then hopefully I will surprise Vishy when I play him on screen. if and when that happens, I would look forward to that.
And I promise I won't put you in a situation where you have to gain weight for your role. I'll be very disciplined till after the movie. So,
oh man, it's so much fun. Nice. All right, guys, is there anything else you'd like to tell before we wind up the stream? Because it has been such a fun stream and such a fun panel, guys.
No, I would like to say something. I'm saying that why don't we do this more often? Yeah, I mean, see, I just like to play chess, so I'm saying, I know Vishy is a busy person. We won't be able to play with him again and again. But, Ananya, you, me, all of us can play once in a while. It'll be nice.
Sir, please check out YouTube channel Samay Raina doing chess since 1 year. 700,000 subscribers.
No, Amit sir, we'll try to make it happen, sir.
Yeah, I can get your contacts and all of that. And maybe we can just have a game someday, Arijit, Ananya.
Yeah. I can always accompany.
I know you as well. So we can play. Rachura, you have to give me some training because I've always wanted to have a trainer here.
Absolutely, sir. It would be my honor.
Yeah.
Rachura, if you are busy, Amish sir, whenever you have time, please check out. No, not somewhere around this time. Sagar Shah, he's one of the finest coaches. I think Rachura will agree.
There is one person who I watch his videos and I really like listening to him.
Who is it?
I've been trying to get his number. Yeah. His name is Advani. What?
Agadmeter.
Just show me your WhatsApp, YouTube.
Aray, chess talk. Chess talk. Yes.
Advani.
I'll give you his number, sir.
What is his name?
I will WhatsApp it to you. You give me your number.
Samay is getting carried away.
Yeah, it's.
Ananya, you were saying something. So sorry.
No, I was just saying that I wanted to brush up my skills a little bit and I couldn't do it by myself. So my coach in LA, Sarko, he's really good. He, in like 3-4 days, just quickly went through openings, just some tactics. It was a lot of fun. So yeah, big shout out to him.
Now Ananya is revealed.
And he's a pretty strong player, no? Ananya, he's like 2,500 we hear. Around 2,500 rated.
That's amazing.
Wow.
But I think he was able to look at the board from my eyes and see what I was acting, and I think that I've not had that in a chess coach before, and I haven't coached in ages, so it was nice.
Yeah. So the guy's name is Jitendra Advani.
Yeah.
Right.
So I want to talk to him and ask him to train me. I like his style.
He'll be so happy. He'll be so happy right now. Oh my God.
I've been trying to get his number here.
I'll get it on. I'll get it to you.
Oh, that'll be great. That'll be great.
Jitendra bhai, if you're listening, remember long ago we had streamed together. Just saying. Anyway.
In fact, I spoke to Dhyani on the email, you know, a couple of weeks ago, like a month ago, and I asked her, I said, can you get me Jitendra Advani's number? And she did try to actually, but then I lost touch.
Amazing.
So what a wonderful game, yeah. You know, my grandmother taught me this game, Vishy, when I was 5 or 6 years old, and since then I've been playing and just enjoying it. Yeah.
And I will take you up on this Catan. I should do that.
Oh yeah, it's you guys must try it. Yeah, this app called Catan Universe is what the app is called. So you download the app, okay, and then you can play the different games on it, and it's really amazing. I love this game.
We can do these tandem games because there is a thing called chess boxing where you box and then you play chess and then you box and play chess. Unfortunately, I can't play a boxer. Because we won't get past the third move. I think we can do Catan chess. Maybe that's one move here or something.
Wow. So many new avenues, guys, from the stream and so much money raised, guys. Please do spread the word and keep donating. The links will still be open. We can feed so many other little children, man. And such fun.
So guys, how do we, I can tell Trik to also get in touch with you guys and, you know, help in donating money. So I'd like to do that as well. I'll tell
Prateek. Yeah, exactly. So I think we'll have the link.
You
guys are sending us the link, right?
Niranjanji, can you send the link in the Zoom chat?
On the chat itself. Amir, you mentioned that you learned how to play chess when you were just 5 or 6 years old and it was your grandmom who taught you. Yeah. After that, did you get any formal training or did you ever play a tournament? How did it go from there?
No, so what happened is I never got any training. I just played with my grandmom, my mom, my uncles, etc. You know, kids and all that. I kept playing. And then I played, the only tournament I've played in my life is, I was in NM College. And in NM College, we had the junior college chess tournament, like just internal college tournament. So like whatever, 2000 kids or whatever. So I won that in the 11th and the 12th.
Oh, so you were like the school champion.
That was the only tournament I ever played in my life. And then I've never played before or after and I've never been trained. So I'm looking forward to that. You know, I mean, the basics, I understand that you know, the number of limited squares you have, you know, you want to try and control the center. And try and develop your pieces so that they come in use, they get more powerful as they get to the center, and you know. So what's up to common sense? You don't need to read.
Now, you keep saying that you haven't been trained, but it didn't come across like that.
I've played a lot.
I've
not got to train ever, so I want to.
And I think also because right after the game, you wanted to analyze it. So I think that's also something that's helped you improve a lot.
I want to know where I made my first error.
And I immediately after you wanted to check it out.
That's I think he already knew. Yes,
yeah,
I mean, he wanted to just relive.
But how wonderful, yeah. So Vishy, when you're in Bombay next, come over here. We'll have a game live, yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah.
There will be much more, there will be opportunities to distract, I guess, on live chess. This is kind of a silent game.
I wish we had connected. I don't know what we'll have to do to distract Vishy.
Did you try your Everything. Strategy? You had like a full-on game strat that you were going to sing a song during the game.
Haan, wo usse se start ho gaya toh main ekdam
harbadaat. Usse start jaise ho gaya toh. Samajh mein nahi aaya. Sab log ghus gaye, direct.
You know, there used to be this, I remember I was a big Bjorn Borg fan when he was playing at the peak of his tennis. So at that time, all of the other players had, because he was almost unbeatable, you know. So all the other players had done this joke, you know, where they said that, how do we beat him? So one guy had said, you know, tie his sweatband, his headband on his feet or something. So these are the ways that you can try and beat him. Wow. I think with Vishy also, we'll have to do something like that.
Desperate times call for desperate measures.
You can have a blindfold match against Vishy Anand. That would be very fun to watch.
Oh no, not good enough. Not good enough.
No, you won't be blindfolded. He will be blindfolded.
No, I know. He'll be blindfolded, but not good enough.
Okay.
He will aank band karke khelega, bhai. He'll be the whole board.
Aank aur kaan dono. Like two senses. I think we can
apna game khel denge, wo bhi kaafi ho jayega, you understand?
Yeah. I mean, Vishy is such a very, very strong player, such a legend, and we had such amazing games today. You know, the first panel also, we never expected that there'll be such amazing players. Sajid
played quite well.
Sajid, yes.
Yeah, not bad.
Super well.
Even Sandeep ji, for that matter.
Yeah.
I think Sajid, Sudeep and Nikhil played really well.
Yeah, Nikhil and Sudeep. Yeah, all three of them played really well.
Yeah.
Manu, how was your experience?
Amazing. Like, for me, it was a big win. The fact that I didn't lose in 5 minutes. मुझे छोड़ के जाना पड़ेगा.
So tell us whether your son helped you or not.
He did help in the beginning. उसके बाद मैंने इतनी ज्यादा गड़बड़े करी. He got frustrated. उसने बोला पापा का कुछ नहीं हो सकता. He's a give up case. Then he walked away. He was like really furious. तुम कर क्या रहे हो? But it was fun. Basically, thank you so much for taking out time and thanks for doing this. Really, really great fun.
It was really amazing, guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
No, it's my mom's birthday today, so I'm going to go up and just spend some time with her.
Happy birthday! Sure.
I will wish her. Yeah, I will.
Yes, yes. Happy birthday to her.
It was always on my bucket list to play against you, Vishy sir. And today that got ticked off. So for me, that's the biggest reward. And I got to play against you. And it was amazing to meet all of you. And I hope we can, for the love of chess, we can continue playing together.
Yeah, we will.
Yeah.
We'll catch up. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Thank you.
Any closing thoughts? Amazing. Any closing thoughts, Arijit? Everybody said something.
Closing thoughts is, big hug to Vishy Anand.
मुश्किल
Let me just take my guitar.
Leave everything and just hear this.
Guitar.
Leave everything and just hear this.
Vishy, he's amazing. He's such an amazing singer.
I know.
Such an amazing singer. I've seen him live so many times and each time he blows my mind. So, I leave everything and I'm sitting on stage. When do we get the chance to get it again?
Let's
see.
By the way, happy birthday to your mom.
Thank you.
Sir, बस एक
सफर मेरा
वाह
है तू ही मेरी मंजिल तेरे बिना गुजारा है दिल है मुश्किल मुझे आजमाती है तेरी कम नो कॉपीराइट
जो मैं तो गा सकता हूँ ना कोई कॉपीराइट नहीं मेरे लिए superb. Thanks, Arijit.
Oh my God.
Oh, that was brilliant.
Was aa gaya. So, all right, guys. With that, we have come to an end of this epic charity stream. Thank you so much, Vishy sir, for being so cool to do this. And guys, bye bye. Take care. Please stay on with us. Actually, we are going to come back. So, we are saying bye bye to all of these amazing people in the panel. Bye bye, guys. Please take care.
Bye. Thank you very much.
Bye.
We'll be right back.